I'll need a container for this. I'll use a regular bottle. First, I'll wipe out any excess moisture from it. Next, I'll grab a scale to measure the precise amounts of the two components. Any silicone-based sealant will work. For example, I'm using 5 grams of sealant. You'll also need a solvent acetone, or gasoline will do. The ratio can vary, say from 1 to 5 to 1:10. I'm going with 1 to 8 for this. Mix everything thoroughly. Here are the samples for comparison: stone, cardboard, wood, and fiber cement roofing. We'll also test if and lead strip can glow underwater. I'm marking the areas we'll treat for easier reference. Let's start applying the silicone coating. We'll coat all the test items one by one. Finished applying the silicone coating. Now, let the items air dry naturally or speed things up with a hairdryer at 300 degrees Celsius. Everything's ready for testing. We'll start with the roofing material. It's clear that after applying the silicone coating, water doesn't stick or soak into the material at all. Now, let's test the wood. The camera might not fully capture it, but the coated wood doesn't absorb water at all. You can see the water slides right off the treated section, way better than the untreated part. The difference will be really obvious on the cardboard. The treated side of the cardboard barely absorbs any moisture. The difference is also striking on the stones. The treated stone stays dry, while the untreated one soaks up water completely. Finally, let's see how the lead strip performs underwater. We'll thoroughly coat a piece of the lead strip with our silicone solution. Now, I'll dry it with a hairdryer to save time instead of letting it air dry. After coating, I'll turn on the lead strip and check the voltage. Perfect, the lead strip is running at 12 volts. Now, I'm submerging the lead strip in water. I'll turn off the lights so you can see it better. What a sight, it works perfectly. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give this a thumbs up.